Hey guys, welcome to Face the TV once again. It's playoff time here, and we have the GSL Egamingbets Cup. We have NIP, not Exostana, they're now called HellRaisers, of course. But for all of you who know them as ASD, well, you can call them that to yourselves. But now they are HellRaisers, they have rebranded. We're into the knife round now. And so we have the maps as well. So this is the interesting part, because we have Dust2 picked by HellRaisers, which is, of course, an absolute must win, because NIP picked Nuke, of course, and we all saw how HellRaisers were handling the Nuke gameplay yesterday. Wasn't too hot at all. They lost against Wizards there. They had a really close game against GamePub there. Generally, it wasn't going well at all for HellRaisers yesterday on Nuke. So we are jumping in now to the pistol round between NIP, who played amazingly, as you would expect, in the Group A. So with IEM Katowice just around the corner, and NIP being probably, you know, a favorite for the finals, of course. We're probably going to see a rough time for HellRaisers here, but let's see how this starts out on Dust2. Of course, this is a great map for HellRaisers. You know, Thorin raised that point quite a few times. But this is really where HellRaisers are going to want to play. And if we just take a quick look at the overview, you can see how they're actually moving around here. So Angel and Adren, you know, taking control of short. And so far, very defensive beginnings from HellRaisers, and they're slowly going to be making a move up mid, it seems. But look at this setup over at Long, Fifflerin, and Exist. They're going to have to react quite quickly here, because it's kind of far to actually, if they end up smoking off, HellRaisers end up smoking off CT spawn and just rushing straight into B. You can see they're going to synchronize. They've got one man who's ready to move in from the tunnels. This can be quite hard. There's no smoke, actually. Just going to go for it straight up on into that bomb site. Here we go. Dozier going to take down Freiburg straight away. And Kucha, can you kill the last remaining player? He does. No losses so far for HellRaisers. They've done a great job entering the bomb site. It's now a three-man retake situation. And Angel's here locking down the halls. So it doesn't look good at all for the ninjas in pajamas, but they're going to try their best to break into this bomb site. It's not looking good so far. They're not getting the kind of frags they need to. Finally, one comes from Fifflerin, but it still is a 4v2, and now he's all alone, and not even the 5-7 can save him. HellRaisers will take the first round, the pistol round, on Dust2, the first map of this best-of-3 playoff for the GSL Egamingbets Cup, which is really going to propel them towards the kind of momentum that they need to really kick off Dust2. Again, they need to enter this map with some really good emotions, and that's just what they're doing now, especially Adren. That's got to feel good, taking down Exist, trying to push mid. GetRight actually buying a scout. You can see what's going on with GetRight over here, trying to, you know, rotate back over to beat Tons, but not going to catch anything. They are being very cautious, our HellRaisers, as NIP try to use these pistols, and they have such awesome raw skill. So, you know, pistol investments like this are actually so good for a team like NIP, who can really hit their shots. Sometimes they only need that one bullet, and here's Forrest. Can he go for it? He cannot hit the first shot. That's kind of painful there. They would have really needed the first kill to come in very quickly if they wanted to stand a chance. And still four players left alive. Very weak GetRight, very weak Freiburg left right now. And there goes down the bomb. So this should be all right. They have this under lock. Freiburg's there hiding in that corner right below the bomb site. And that's going to be it. Angel will deal with him. So 2-0 and kicking it off. It is very considered from HellRaisers. You can see their comfort coming in. They have no, you know, quarrel to play things very slow if they want to, not feeling rushed. They just seem generally quite methodical at the moment. So hopefully they are going to keep this up. We're going to have another eco round, of course. This time a full eco coming in from ninjas in pajamas. No deals or anything like that. So that is, of course, HellRaisers. You know, they will figure that out very quickly. And actually, NIP going to go with a rush through Long, and I think HellRaisers have kind of caught on to this now. They're bringing the information to their teammates. Here comes a grenade from Adren. That's going to be very painful indeed. Just Exist and Freiburg remaining. Freiburg, there he is, over in the tunnels, and he's not going to find much over here. They did manage to drop two players, but that's not really going to make a huge difference. At least ninjas aren't going to get, you know, a little bit of extra money for those kills, but that's really all it is. It's nothing game-changing. in any sense. So Freiburg's just waiting for a sneaky kill here. I think there's a smoke to try to block off Vision to mid. So they have no idea at all where Freiburg is. And he's going to try his best here to try to make something happen. I mean, if he was able to get a quick one-on-one to get a weapon, and you can see he's going to be going over here to try to find himself a weapon. But was Hellraisers, you know, were they good enough on hiding one of the drops? Because there should be a weapon, I think. I think we saw one of the Hellraisers players swap out a weapon. Actually, looks like they did swap out all the good weapons. So he can only manage to find a P250. But very, very good presence of mind, you know, first of all, trying to look for those guns as the first objective. And a second objective is getting an exit frag, or just, he has a lot of time to play with. He can let them plant the bomb. It's very likely they're going to win the round anyway. So he's just thinking, all right, let's try to make the most of this. If he gets a frag, that's some money for him at not much of a loss. So he's just trying to get the best possible scenario. And that can often be this exit frag situation where they can get them to come closer to make his life easier. But he will fall down. And I do love how Freiburg played it, because he honestly tried to make the best of that. Try to give himself the strongest chance to make a frag happen, which would have been something at the very least. But here we have the first buy round coming in from the ninjas. And we have Fiffler in on that AWP. And we've got Freiburg and Getright manning the B-bomb site here. You see Freiburg probably will float back a little bit to mid, but it seems like the way they're playing this at the moment is having two guys on B, and they're not very forward on short because they don't have a man on mid. You really need the kind of short mid combo for it to really work very effectively. So they're playing a very defensive setup here with long rotation times. And Markloff going to take down Freiburg. Great movement through the double doors and taking over mid now. So this is the big vulnerability for this kind of play from NIP. And it's being exploited very well by the Hellraisers. And they're going to make their way for that plant now as they know that the site is clear. And it's a three player retake situation again. This time it's not a pistol round, so there's a lot more money at stake. If they're going to go, you know, for it, they're probably going to die, or their chances of making it are so low. If you're looking at a pure numbers game, it's probably not worth that investment to try to win just this round when they have three weapons left. So that is kind of the play that they decided, and that's something that they would have considered at the start of the round when they made this kind of play to kind of give up mid, to have these long rotation times. Fifrin, very nice little flick shot there. Forest as well is going to be able to catch Angel perhaps, but no, Angel very, very good there on realizing what's happening. Fifrin's coming out huge with a lot of frags, but Hellraisers know that they need to go and try to deny these weapons from NIP. They managed to take down one, so, and that's actually a huge result for them, because now, you know, it's kind of it's a tough situation to really deal with, because only two weapons left alive. Do they, you know, invest all the money in a buy, or how do they play it? Looks like they will try to invest in a buy here. Forrest actually has quite a bit of cash left. I believe it was 3K we saw him. Oh no, he did actually spend that money, so that's good. So they did go for that full buy. But you can see they're very limited on grenades here. And Dust 2, you know, it is not like Inferno, a map where, you know, or Nuke rather, where nades are much, are very, very important. You can get away with not having as many nades on this map because of the amount of open spaces you're dealing with. But we can see now the setup is a bit less defensive from NIP, trying to get that information, trying to see what's happening over at mid, not giving it up completely. And after the ninjas saw that it was occupied by Hellraisers, they decided to back away there. But that information does go to the players over at A from NIP. So they're going to be very aware, and at the drop of a hat, they'll be able to rotate very quickly. They won't really need much time to understand what's happening here. But look at this. Adrian in very good position here to deal with the guy, the boxman right at the back of Plateau, Freiburg. And Freiburg's head will get popped off by Kucha's AK-47 as they now move into the bomb site. Another frag from Kucha opening up the site completely now. And again, a three-person retake. But this time, they can actually go for it. They've got one player really weak in Angel, and the remaining two players, Dozier and Kucha, only have rifles, so this is very doable. The only real issue is that Fifflerin, you know, with that AWP, makes him a little bit slower, a little less dynamic moving into this, but he's going to try working his way through the door here. Beautiful play with Fifflerin's AWP. The opening frag, that's going to cue the remaining teammates to jump in on into the site, and they get the frags. One, two, three, all off of the back of Fifflerin's wonderful play with the sniper rifle. So yeah, Fifferin doing a great job. He's top fragging by far here, having a very good few rounds at the beginning of this game. So let's see how this goes now, because of course, again, let's just check out the economic situation. This is one of those positions whereby if HellRaisers get a plant and lose, they'll be okay. If they lose outright, they can still just about buy, but after that, they're going to be in a very bad situation economically. The CTs is much more fragile for NIP. They really need to hold on to the next two rounds. It's really, really important. And look at this strong rush coming from HellRaisers, running in blind. Here they go. Managed to make two frags on into that site. And Fifflerin has to retreat from CT spawn. The position is compromised. And they're all going to come around. Perhaps one is going to go long and put a couple men for short here. As Get Right is with Freiburg there, pushing on through. And they're going to get Fifflerin around through to long here. And it's going to be really slow for Fifferin to get around, because with that AWP, you've got to be absolutely sure you're taking these angles correctly. You can't rush it. And here we go. Get Right and Freiburg making their way down to the bombsite. Get Right will fall Freiburg as well. And that is going to tell Fifferin that enough is enough. And he's going to back away. Here he goes to try to get some exit frags. Now he's really going to be careful. They're too close to run away. He's got to make the shots. Oh, and he's not able to do so. He's going to lose the AWP. And that is a huge issue. You can maybe look at Fifflerin's play there and be kind of like, well, you know, maybe he shouldn't have tried to commit for that cheeky last shot, because the shot just as his two teammates died, just after his two teammates died, that actually, him taking the time to try to make that shot actually enabled his opponents to close the distance between Fifflerin and themselves enough so that Fifflerin couldn't escape. And then he was committed to try to fight it out. And with the AWP, he's most certainly going to get swarmed down. So it was a tough call. It's one of those things. But NIP, they've only got one round now to the five of HellRaisers, who, with that very, very well-executed catwalk rush, managed to actually take that round down. And in this round, we're seeing some very effective picks coming off here from Kucha. But of course, it's a pistol round, and Kucha, he was coming out huge yesterday for Exis On, as he were tagged then. But of course, now they're HellRaisers. But he was doing very well for them, and they're having a very shaky day. I mean, their results were very strange on the Group B play, and they barely managed to actually go through to the playoffs today. As we see Forest get dropped by Kucha. But it is, of course, very easy round against these pistols. It's one of the harder maps to deal with when it comes to trying to win that eco round. Of course, it's always going to be difficult to win eco rounds, but you don't get as many opportunities on a map like Dust 2 when the terrain is so open. I mean, how can you effectively use the pistols? It can be very difficult. I mean, you tend to see a lot of stacks, a lot of rushes, a lot of grenade play to coming in, and always, you know, you see teams, you know, throwing the smoke on mid to try to at least hide, you know, exactly what you're doing, like whether you're stacking or not. So it's very difficult to deal with on Dust 2, so it's no surprise that they went down there. But great little AWP battle there. Fifferin coming out on top against Markloff. That's going to really allow NIP to feel comfortable, as now HellRaisers lose a very important player over at long. We can see them actually occupying the middle space again. And it's all about, you know, occupying middle. If you're able to occupy middle, you can deny information, you can really cut off the rotations. And right now, they're just trying to see what they can get at this point in time. And so far, of course, they've managed to work their way up the catwalk. They've got a man in the tunnels to try to catch any NIP player who, you know, would decide, okay, maybe we don't have enough information. Let's try to see if they are occupying tunnels. You know, they have a man to deal with that with that kind of play. They got a man over at Cat, a couple men over there to try to push on in. So they managed to make the entry frags. Things are looking better and better. Forest in this duel, he's just wondering, when will this guy die? Angel finally does die. And Forest is in control of the situation. Going to force back Dozier, who's going to run into Exist here. And there he is with the FAMAS. And Dozier now, he is stuck between a rock and a hard place. Exist helps him out with that. And now it's just one player, or two players left, Adren and Kucha. But in that time, they managed to get the bomb down over at B. So It's a very good situation for Hellraisers, although Adrenus is not very healthy at all, to say the least. Forest making his way in, does catch Kucha there, but it's a trade. Adren only with 3 points of health. Here goes the defuse from Forest. He hasn't got he hasn't got a kid either. So that was almost an impossible situation. Even though Adren had such low health, he perhaps could have been able to avoid bullets from Forest so that his 3 health wouldn't come into play and just delay long enough. And unless there was a kit lying around, that would have been really tough for the ninjas. So really, really, really tough start. CT side can be really hard. Oh my god, Marklov through the door. Freiburg, that is just horrendous there. And they are moving all the way through towards this B-bomb site. Just get right with the P2000. Cannot do a single thing. And they're just falling like flies now, of course, in the next pistol round. So ninja's going to be going down 8-1. Doesn't feel very good. The pressure is on them. Of course, it is generally a lot easier to play the T side on Dust 2 than it is the CT side. So we'll see now if ninjas with this buy are going to be able to do anything to try to save themselves against the Hellraisers. Hopefully, for their sake, they're able to do something. They have a double AWP setup now in Fiffler and in Get Right. So how are they going to use this? I do wonder. Let's look. Right now we have 3 players moving through the tunnels. They're not going to be pushing on too fast. Oh my god, Kucha! Oh wow, a free frag on to Get Right through the smoke. That's massive. That AWP is just completely taken out for free. And Markov even going to take down Fifflerin's AWP for free. This is just so gutting for the ninjas now. Forest will make a kill onto Marklov and Exist picks up the AWP that Get Right or Fifflerin had to take down Angel. But the B bomb site, it should be pretty open, more or less. I mean, they have a player rotating there. You know, NIP are feeling their own kind of vulnerabilities at this point. But Hellraisers, they're deciding to use the time in the round to their advantage and play it slowly. Because with this few players for the CT side, you have to move around a lot. And you can catch players out of position on the rotations. And that's really where the weaknesses can come in for ninjas right now. And you can see Forrest moving back through mid. They've worked out what's happening. Here comes Adren. Got to win this duel against Exist. He cannot do it. Beautiful shot from Exist. Now looking for the next one. And what a save from ninjas. Losing both AWPs right at the start of the round in a ridiculous fashion. And that is just NIP. You know, you have 3 players, any one of them able to perform incredible feats of skill under pressure to save a round. And that is exactly what happened. And it couldn't have happened any sooner. Marklov going for a pot shot again over on the mid. So this time it looks like we're going to see an A split from the movement on long. They've taken over long, but there is actually 3 players from the ninjas. They may not fully commit to this. They will have the time to decide to actually go back, but the grenades are sailing in over here, and the ninjas have a perfect setup. They have all the players over on the A side, but one just neutralizing the play over at long. Marklov struggling to make a frag. He does get it on Forest, but now he's so low. One HE will take him out, and here it comes. Marklov goes down to the heavy explosive from Fifflerin, and there you go. What a flawless round from the ninjas. They read that movement so well, and they positioned themselves perfectly. And that is the problem. I mean, I think Hellraisers were falling back onto a strategy, a similar strategy that worked well previously. But this time, the positioning from NIP was just too strong. Different getting blinded there. I'm going to go for the peek again. Dozier sitting there. Strong grenade onto Dozier. Good chunk of his health missing now. Look at this, Forrest and Freiburg mixing it up, playing on mid. A lot of diverse setups from NIP. Oh, wow, Angel, he knows. He knows exactly what is up. Freiburg. What is he going to do here? Is he going to actually creep through the smoke? Looks like he's going to do just that to try and flank the players of Hellraisers who are charging on into the cap, you know, through the catwalk onto the A bomb site. Here they go. 3 players left for ninjas. Can they do this? What a reaction from Angel. Freiburg just demolished to try his hand. Try where Freiburg failed. And so far he's doing a good job. 2-on-4 still though. But the Hellraisers are actually very low overall. All the players below 50 health more or less. Adren, the only one who could be considered healthy with 65, but Markloff popping off the head of Get Right. And Fiffler, and again, moving in from long. I hope this time he doesn't lose his AWP, because there is no need to lose his AWP. And he's going to lose the AWP there. So 9-3 at the moment in favor of HellRaisers, as they show everybody why they are so good on Dust 2. And they're looking so much better than yesterday. Yesterday, we were seeing HellRaisers just... I don't know, they... In all the individual situations, okay, maybe Nuke is one of the weaker maps for them, but even in the one-on-ones that they were taking, they're just underperforming all over the place. It didn't look very good. It's looking much different today. And Exist gonna make his way back around through to long here with Forest. And we can see on the minimap that the players of HellRaisers actually moving all the way towards B. In fact, they have given up the entirety of the map. They only occupy the tunnels at this point, and we can see that they're about to rush on in here. And here you go, you got Freiburg once again. He is the man who is just sitting in, you know, behind that box on the plateau. And Freiburg's going to go down as Dozier moves in, managing to take out Get Right as well. Bifferin trying to make the shots happen right now, but it's going to be really tough for them to enter the site. 3-on-3, Forrest dives in, and Markloff takes him straight on down. Adren got the flank covered, no problem at all. Exist and Fifferin, here goes Fifferin into Adren's crosshair, and Adren makes the kill happen. So clean, so thorough at HellRaisers, they make it 10-3. So we can see the money situation right now. Not looking super good for NIP. They have to go for the eco here. And that's going to be, of course, moving into the last round after this one. They'll get, you know, one more shot at a buy after this. And then that's going to be it for the first half. Then the pressure will be on them to have a massive terrorist side on Dust 2. And if you're just joining us, this is the playoffs. All the matches today are going to be best of three. We have the four teams that qualified for Group A and B of the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And the best of three coming up after this. It's going to be clan-mystik and Kick Gaming. It's a great shot from Markloff there. Freiburg, and he wanted to get some information. Moving on into mid, just going for it. Gets taken down. And now the rest of his teammates are going to go for it. Angel defending the weapon that NIP want to play for. Quite well, pulling out the pistol. Here it goes. Pistol on pistol. Angel takes it down and swaps his way onto the AWP. Do like the red line AWP, I gotta say. I am a fan. So 11-3. We have a buy round now from NIP. No sniper rifles at all. And they've just been getting kind of outplayed on the CT side here. There's not much they've been able to really accomplish. And we haven't seen really any specific strategies from HellRaisers. They have, you know, put up a few, you know, good rushes, a good, you know, some good splits, but it's more the rounds where they play more individually and play more reactively and dynamically that they actually have success against NIP. Here we go. Fifflerin makes his way back up to the ramp here on the A bomb site, trying to take down Angel, and Adren does get Angel. And this is looking like a good round so far for NIP. They've got only three players left to deal with. They've stopped HellRaisers from getting position on the site. So this is really where you need a sick clutch to come out from HellRaisers. And Markloff is going to start it off with two frags. Great play with the AWP so far. Freiburg going to come to the flank though. So Markloff, he's very aware of this. He has the experience right now. What can he do with it? Here he is with the HE. Got to be so careful of his back. He's feeling someone breathing down his neck right now as Markloff jumps down to escape that towards CT spawn. Here he is, making his way slowly, but he cannot look everywhere at once, and Get Right's going to abuse that. There it is. So 4-11 on the first half on the first map for the first best of three today. Good halves all around. NIP, though. They need a big result now. Of course, it all rests on this pistol round. I think that's the thing that a lot of commentators are saying. They're like, oh my god, the pistol round's so important. And they're just like cringing to themselves because they know that everyone says that. Obviously, it is very important. But in this situation, of course, if Ninjas were to lose that pistol round, it's another two rounds kind of guaranteed. So already HellRaisers are going to be on like 14 rounds. So that is not a reality they want to experience. And they have a lot of skill they can abuse. But the thing is that HellRaisers, they are really feeling it right now. They are looking way better than yesterday. Maybe it's just because they get to play their map first. Here we go. It's like Angel's going to deny Fifflerin. Now that is tough. The battle for position for map control is being won by HellRaisers right now as they put the stop over it. Long, and look at that again. And Forest goes down there as well. So what do? You've lost two men at the same choke point. You just keep going for it. They're trying to do it, but Doja takes down another one. And it's Get Right who moves in over towards Cat onto the site. Gets denied as well. Finally, Dozier goes down, but Exist needs to find four more frags for the ace if he wants to prevent potentially a terrible situation from NIP. Here Kucha comes. Look at this beautiful team play. There's two men, and Exist, he manages to make the movement so that it's a one-on-one, so he can, you know, maximize his chances, but they do take him down nonetheless, and there it is. That's the 12-4. That's the pistol round on the second half, won by HellRaisers, and that is the chances of NAP to win Dust2 basically all but gone. Let's see if they can do it, though. It is NIP. You never want to say that NIP has lost the match before we've seen the 16 rounds, but it's definitely looking terrible. Can see Exist, you know, ready with that grenade. That really tells us a lot, but they must have made the call. Fifflerin must have made the call not to go for that in the end. Angel now dropping Freiburg in the distance. And again, you know, I made the point before about how tough it is with pistol rounds on this map. I think it's much harder as the TTs on the pistol rounds, but it's still not that good either for the Ts with their pistols. Again, you still have to compete with all these long ranges. At least you can focus, you can swarm much more effectively as the T side on one position, and that's what we're going to see now. But look at this setup. Dozier, he has info now. His team knows where to throw the nades. Perfect position. His job there wasn't to get any frags. It was to get the info, and now nades can fly in. They've got perfect knowledge of what's happening. Here they charge into the bombsite with their Glocks. Beautiful shot from Exist. He's going to take down Angel. And there's one over at Graffiti. Exist is going to grab him as well. Durant. Looking at Fifflerin's head, can't quite get it just yet. Fifflerin's going straight for the plant. Will he get it? No! He will not. A magnificent bit of Famous work from Adren to stop that eventuality. And 13-4, the score now. But we're going to see the buy coming in from NIP. So the one pistol was good enough for them. The one EK was good enough for them. And let's see how they do this. They have, you know, a bunch of flashes, and they're all going in now. Angel, look at this play from Angel, moving straight up mid. This is really amazing from Angel. Miraculous shot there onto Exist. He's looking for even more though. And this is problematic now because the fast play of NIP, which they were making to take control of Long, which they successfully did, now they're feeling like we're really shit. You know, we're really pressured right now. We're really, really pressured from behind. This is a bad situation. Angel finally does go down, but they lost a lot of time in worrying about Angel, and now they do have slowly pushed up to crossover. They don't have any smokes, though, so this is a very bad situation. Dozier can just easily make the shots over from CT spawn. Without those smokes, that position is very hard. You got to win the Angels. Just running straight across is very tough. Here goes Dozier, and he almost gets the angle he needed in time, but there you go. They're going to go for the rush across. Get Right takes down Adren, and Fifflerin gets it in the bombsite. Going to take down Dozier. Good movement there from Fifflerin as it becomes now a 2-on-2. And tension is high as they absolutely need to win this round to stay in this match. And here goes Kucha coming in for the flank. Get Right. Is he going to be smart to this? The bomb is down by crossover. Here's Fifflerin. He knows Markloff's nearby, but Markloff, such great reactions. And Kucha going to catch Get Right. Oh, dear. Get Right. He moved from his position as soon as he heard his teammate fall to the AWP bullet of Markloff. So 14-4. And it's looking like we're seeing a very fast first map if something insane doesn't happen from ninjas right now. So here we go. Got some movement from NIP into the tunnels. Now, it would be very curious. A move that's often very nice. Oh my god, Markloff is on point today. And even Angel is trying to push Catwalk here. And that's the the two-man combo that's really strong. Getting a couple men over at short end, the support coming in from the mid AWPer can be really effective if the timing is good. And Angel right now has to back away. He's taking a lot of damage there. And Kucha going to be pushing the tunnels. So we have a situation where HellRaisers have a very good idea of exactly where the ninjas are. And Kucha, he's going to die there. Kucha dying there kind of gives a few more options to ninjas, allowing them to have more breathing room, more space to work with. So it would have been nice if Kucha had shown himself that he was there, but not actually gone for the shots to risk dying, because that would just put the pressure on NIP on NIP because they'd be surrounded. But here they are, all in mid, looking for the flank there. Oh, Xyz is turning his back at the wrong moment, and Doji is going to catch him. But here goes Adren, ready to defend that tunnel, and he's going to do so, dropping the bomb also. So here goes Get Right. He does manage to take down Dozier, looking for the second. He's going to grab it on Adren. There's two more players left and only 23 points of health for Get Right. He has 15 seconds. He has to just go. That's exactly what he's going to do. There goes the grenade. This could be good, though. Oh, my God. He's going to explode Angel with that grenade. And he has no time. Has to go for it, Markloff. He's going to capitalize and grab himself the AWP and put an end to the shenanigans from NIP there. But that was a great round from HellRaisers. More or less just shutting down everything from the ninjas that they try to accomplish. And I was going to say that I would have liked to see something interesting, like some mid play with the smoke on the CT spawn, you know, swarming the AWPer. But we're seeing a lot of AWP battles here over on mid from T spawn to CT spawn. And it's going to actually go the way of ninjas in pajamas at the moment, as HellRaisers are left only with three men. And as the CT side on Dust 2, this is very, very tough to deal with. It's going to require quite a huge clutch from one of the players here. And it's just Dozier left. So if Dozier's feeling like he can take down, if he can take down four players, then sure. But he doesn't even really need to think about saving all that much. But let's see how this goes. If we press tab, we can see the money situation. So it would definitely be nice for him to at least save a gun here. But he's certainly not going to win this round. But yeah, I mean, often it can be very effective to take over tunnels, make that play on mid, go for that B split. We didn't see that once, actually, I don't think. I think we saw that once on a pistol round, kind of a very delayed B split from HellRaisers when they were playing the T side, but haven't really seen that much. And if you have opponents that are putting AWPers on mid, it can be quite effective sometimes. But either way, it's just going to be Dozier trying to survive. And he's going to get spotted there. And there it is. Missing the shot, Bibler, and oh dear. Does get the second one, though. So good play to him. He's been generally very good today so far on Dust 2. Despite the fact that NIP are in a 15-5 situation, Bibler has been playing really well with the AWP. So you can see, actually, how the scoreboard is looking. Can Dozier evade the shot? There is no shot even arriving to try to tank him. But it's going to be Xyz right now looking for the head here. This is always an interesting duel, this one. Which angle do they choose? And look at this. Geroy's going to actually charge through. He wants to take control of CT spawn in mid. And that's what he's going to do. Freiburg trying to work it. But Markloff going to take him down over it short. And these pistols so far able to make it to a 4-on-4 situation. And look at Angel. He's going to get cheeky with this Deagle. Oh, and he's going to pop off the head of Geroy. Lovely stuff there, as Markloff is still, he's going to go for it, just jumping towards Forrest's AWP, and that's never a good thing to do. Top tip, don't jump at Thoris when he's got the AWP in his hands. He may be a very good rifler, but he is very good with the AWP as well. Angel looking to make some more magic occur here, but look at this, Forrest has spotted him. But oh, there it is, Angel, before he can take the chance for a shot, he's going to fall. So there's no more chance, it seems like. Bell raises right now. Just Dozier and me. And there we go. So Ninjas in Pajamas taking another round. But it's just one more round for HellRaisers to take this. They're going to go for another eco. They have such a huge buffer to work with. I mean, look at this. NIP have to win 10 rounds in a row. Rather, sorry. 9 rounds to actually bring it to a tie, rather. And that is a long, that's going to take a long time. They have a lot of rounds to play with. They can afford, you know, some ecos. They can afford to even do something crazy, unorthodox, for the next few rounds, but after that it's going to get a bit scary. So it looks like they're just going to play it quite simply here. A kind of a somewhat standard setup with the pistols. Nothing crazy. And here come the grenades. NIP moving towards long, going to try to take it over. And there you go. Freiburg coming in with two great frags. Always strong on those entry frags. And NIP, they pick up the pace, charging onto the A bomb site here. There goes Markov with the CZ75. Doesn't get the headshot that he needs. And he gets overwhelmed. Markov goes down. NIP with another round, but now we have the bite from Hellraisers. And now a situation they absolutely need to avoid with their double AWP setup is losing one early to that in that AWP duel. It's a big risk to go for that. But let's see what happens. Exist gonna smoke it up there from Suicide. And Forrest goes for a quick shot. And yeah, the smoke is gonna prevent any craziness there as well. And Mark Clough. You can see he's over at the A bomb site with his AWP. Very nice position here for Markloff. And we have Kucha watching the tunnels from Plateau with his AWP. So that's now we have the sense where the AWPs are. We can see the kind of setup. So there's no AWPs really on mid. And that's actually can be quite nice because if they do decide to go through mid, rifle close range can actually be much better if they try a considered push with all of them. But it looks to be that they're actually making a move on short at the moment. Fifflerin, though, he needs to find a frag here. And look at that. He does find the headshot onto Angel. And Forrest looking for some kind of rotation because they know now, okay, CTs are thinking we're going to go for A. So they're going to rotate someone to try to take that angle. Forrest is ready for it. Markov, look at this beautiful stuff. It goes for the no-scope. It's going to miss. And Markov picks off Exist as well. But Fifflerin, very, very responsible trade in from him now. And Adren and Kucha are the ones remaining. Kucha was the B-man with the AWP. And Adren is just rifling at the moment. It's a 2-on-3. It's a very tough situation. They're not going to go for it. It looks like they want to make the save. And you can't really blame them, because after this round's loss, you know, they just did a full buy after ecoing twice. They don't want to have a situation where they're just all pistols again. And winning this retake is just not likely at all. So save the AWP, save the rifle. Good play. Now NIP going to go for hunting. See if they can find something here. Look at that, Fifflerin is going to run into them soon. But the bomb's about to explode. There will be a few more seconds. Oh, wow, Fifflerin takes down Adren. Oh, poor Adren. So it's just one weapon left for them. And how do they decide to use this? Do they play? How will they play around the AWP? Just stick him on mid, or what do they do? It's always very cool to see what the teams decide. Because there's a lot of options with this. You can actually get aggressive with it. Having a few men going in front. Because, you know, you have people to pick up the AWP as well if they die. So here you go. Adren trying to lock down the tunnels with just a 5-7. You'd be surprised what a 5-7 can accomplish, but Get Right is going to shut him down. Nice picking short to use the AWP with. That's very nice angle. Very, and this is something we have to remember as well, that NIP know that an AWP was saved. So they're going to be trying to think, okay, how can we actually minimize our potential losses with there? And Markloff, unfortunately, shooting the AWP back in to the T-side of mid there by Xbox. And he wants that AWP badly. And this is probably, he wants to make a play for that. He can see it, but it's just too dangerous to go for it. And it's really hard for NIP to even shoot the AWP away. And they may want to try to do that, but here you go. 3-on-3 situation with Hellraisers. Still with the one AWP from Kucha. Markloff gonna go down. He wanted that AWP and it was the death of him. Here's Dozier though. And there's Get Right. Force making the headshot. So just got Kucha left and going for the save again. That's always good. The AWP is such a heavy investment. You don't really want to ever belittle the kind of investment that it is. You need to keep it around for multiple rounds, keep it alive for multiple rounds if it's to be cost effective. So same old story here. NIP are climbing their way back slowly but surely. But they still have so far to go. And Kucha, wow, barely not getting tagged with a bullet. Just one bullet could take him down. AK bullet to the chest would do the job. And there is one to the head. Kucha falls, loses the AWP. Unfortunate timing there. And that's going to be very sad for him. But at least they can still have an AWP on Markloff here. So no more double AWP setup. But still, they are looking decent on the buy. They got a lot of grenades to their name. They got all the head armor. In fact, actually, Markov wasn't able to afford head armor. That's actually kind of fine, though, because, of course, you know, the AKs will take you down instantly with a headshot, so it doesn't matter that much. But here we go. We got Forest taking control of Long. They've dropped two men so far. So here they are, all three together. They've got to be quick, actually, if they want to make this work. The numbers advantage is their strength at the moment, but that doesn't last for long, because as soon as HellRaisers realize what's happening, they're going to be on top of this. And here we go, Fifth in, making his way in now. Last man standing. He's got three men to take down. Missing the spray. Dozier will not go down. And there you go, 16-9. GG's all around. First map will go to HellRaisers, which is, of course, Exostana Dragons. So we'll move on into the second map momentarily, which will be Nuke. And yesterday, Nuke was a little bit embarrassing for Exostana Dragons or HellRaisers. They lost to Wizards. I mean, Wizards did play great, but Exostana or HellRaisers is going to have to get used to that. HellRaisers, definitely, they weren't playing their best. Going to need to see something marvelous from them. Otherwise, NIP, they're so strong on Nuke, they're just going to run over. I mean, my prediction is probably something in the region of 16-5 or something. Something quite dominant. But let's see. There it is again. HellRaisers, they are actually looking much better today, because yesterday it was the individual skill, the duels, where they were kind of faltering, where you'd really like to see them, you know, winning, where they usually do. But today we saw a very strong play on the T side, and that really propelled them into a very dominant victory in the end, 16-9 on Dust 2. So yeah, I'm very curious how this could go. I'm expecting a dominant performance, but I wouldn't be surprised if HellRaisers make something special happen. But it is NIP, so we're going to find out momentarily. So Nuke is just loading up. And remember, the guys, this is the first game for the playoffs today. NIP, and they qualified from Group A with Kick Gaming, and we'll see Kick Gaming in the next best of three playing against Mystic, Clan Mystic with Kenny S and so on and so forth. The Frenchies doing really, really well. They had some very strong results yesterday. They're performing very well. Kick Gaming are definitely going to be in for a very tough game. But we'll head up a very fast break, guys, whilst we let the players load into the map. So see you right after.